Consider the lionfish. It floats like an underwater butterfly, but it stings like a bee. The lionfish isn't supposed to be here, but like most invasive species, it arrived innocently enough, and it isn't going away.
The lesson here is to try to make sure that we don't do something to bring another invasive species here into North Carolina or any environment where they don't belong.
The environment the lionfish is threatening is about 30 to 40 miles offshore in 140 feet deep water around the natural and man-made reefs and shipwrecks along the coast. More on that in a moment. Because to understand this beautiful and troublesome invasive species, let's go back on land for a moment. Kudzu might be the state's most visible and well-known invasive species. You can't miss spotting it along the roadsides. Kudzu was brought from its native China and Japan because people thought it looked nice and it controlled erosion. Trouble is, kudzu grows incredibly fast, and like most invasive species, when it gets out of control, it outcompetes the native trees and shrubs by climbing all over them and killing them by blocking out the sun. Kudzu takes over. Just like kudzu, the lionfish is outcompeting the native reef fish. It's reducing the biodiversity of the reef environment. That's the variety of fish living in an area. In short, it's taking over its new environment.
The lionfish certainly are a beautiful fish, but since they are voracious predators and they reproduce very quickly, they don't have any natural predators to keep the populations in check. The population has just exploded here, and it's really causing a problem for our area because they're eating us out of house and home.
We're concerned about the impacts because of how lionfish can change the reef-fish community. So we're talking about changes to biodiversity. We've seen higher changes to biodiversity from lionfish than we do from many other types of stressors on reef systems.
In this lab at the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration's Research Center in Beaufort, Dr. James Morris is one of many scientists studying lionfish. By examining the contents of lionfish stomachs, researchers say the lionfish is eating away the state's commercial fishing industry.
You basically have two categories that we're concerned about. One are ecologically important species. So these are species that are, let's say, important for the diet of other native top-level predators like grouper and snapper. If lionfish are consuming those species or over-consuming those species, then that diet is not available for some of the other commercially important species, for example. And that disrupts the balance. The other concern is that they're actually predating directly the juveniles of commercially important species like snapper and grouper.
That's right. Lionfish are not only eating the food supply of grouper and snapper, they're also eating juvenile grouper and snapper. Lionfish eat about half their body weight each day, and they can live for 30 years. What's more, scientists tracking the life cycle of lionfish say females produce about 2 million eggs per year, and they are able to spawn year-round. That improves the survival chances for lionfish and gives them a greater opportunity to overwhelm the native species. We'll never know for sure what started the lionfish invasion, but the fish were first spotted off the coast of Florida in the early 1980s, and DNA tracking has narrowed it down to 7 or 8 separate fish. It's believed folks emptying their aquariums into the water put the fish into an environment where it shouldn't be, but it thrives. From Florida in the mid-1980s, lionfish have spread incredibly fast. They were first spotted off the North Carolina coast in 2000, which means in 13 years, lionfish have firmly established themselves in the Carolinas. It appears lionfish can't survive much farther north because the water temperature gets too cold. However, because the water is warmer, lionfish now range into the Gulf of Mexico and the Caribbean. Lionfish are moving towards South America.
Actually, they're the perfect invasive species, right? Because you have no predator for them, so nobody's going to attack you. They don't know how to deal with them. I've seen some recent graduate work studies that show that the local fish that we have here, they're just confused by them. They don't know how to react to them because they're not their natural predators. So they know how to react to the normal predators that they have, but these are new predators and they have different tactics. So they flare out their fins and then they suck the fish in when they come in. So our native species don't really know how to deal with them.
So these are the spines of lionfish, and they're venomous, and they are there for venom defense. They're to defend from getting eaten. So a predator coming from behind would have a hard time consuming that lionfish.
Scientists say lionfish present such a successfully destructive combination, voracious appetite, rapid reproduction, and no natural predators. It appears the only way to slow the lionfish invasion is for people to swim into the picture.
We have demonstrated now that you can successfully control lionfish on artificial reefs, and the best way to do that is to physically remove them.
Welcome forward to the inaugural If You Can't Beat 'Em, Eat 'Em spearfishing tournament.
So more than a dozen coastal businesses, nonprofits, and government agencies met in Beaufort this summer and organized the state's first lionfish fishing derby, a way to help the environment and the economy.
It's not a fish that most people are going to think of as a food source. It's not that easy to capture. We haven't had very good luck capturing them. But it's actually a very nice, lightweight white meat, kind of like a flounder, very good to eat, actually really easy to clean. The only issue with it is capturing them.
Since the lionfish is here to stay, it would be very difficult to get rid of them. The goal is to thin out the lionfish population from a reef area and help balance the ecosystem.
What we're hoping, at least with this tournament, is to maybe clear different areas. We're going to take some of our boats to specific lionfish-laden areas like the Naco, where we know that we see lionfish all the time. It'll be like a pruning process, so we hope to create little oases where there are no lionfish and that our native species can grow and develop from there.